Hey everybody! Sorry we were off for the past 2 weeks. We had some issues, as Elvis would say.
Issues, man, issues.
But we're back, and we're going to be back for, what, three more weeks? Tonight, we're going to be recording some a couple of episodes to go into the podcast. So if you're listening to this, if you're watching this video, don't listen to the podcast or don't watch the video and listen to the
podcast. Watch this.
Don't watch this. Nothing to see here. Anyway,
I don't.
we're going to skip the word of the day today, and we're going to go right into humping like a herd of horny wampas, gripping our lightsabers until the pink turns purple, and always letting the Wookiee win. Punch it, Chewie, because it's time for the MythWits, the show dedicated to all things geek pop culture, drenched in absurdity and coated with sarcasm. Every week, we bring you news, interviews, no interview this week, from the Geekiverse. We do our damnedest to be funny. Probably no news. Well, no, Ian's going to do some news. We do our damnedest to be funny, but there are no guarantees. I am your host, Peter Bryant. Joining me this week is Mike Kafes.
I got new. I'm down in the dungeon. I am now the dungeon master.
Jack Ballard.
Hello.
And proof that ADD sperm cells can still make babies, Ian Kafes.
The people have spoken, Pete. They have voted, and I am back on the show.
Yes, the king is back. The person voted several times.
Right. The person. This person right here. He's right here on the screen. This person voted a bunch of times.
That guy.
So what are you saying, Mike?
Great.
So he won the primary, much like Hillary. Sorry, I mean, what?
Winning's winning.
That's what Hillary said, right? All right, so tonight
that's where I'm where I am today.
Yeah, tonight we're gonna do so we're gonna do a couple things here. We're gonna do Bet the Geek. We're gonna do MatchWits game. Mike, what's your game? Kickstarter. What's it called?
It's a Kickstarter Crapstarter. That's the working name of it.
Okay, all right. Well, we can go with that. And then we're gonna Mike and Jack were talking to me earlier and said that they had some questions about the election and they want Magic 8-bit. To help us out with that. And Ian is going to give us an update on some of the new stuff to know about Nintendo, right?
Hoo-hoo-hoo, I'm excited.
Well, you know what? Hey,
being that he's excited. For the first time in a long time.
Mike, you want him to go first? How about that? We let the newcomer go first.
That's fine
okay.
with me.
All right, Ian. So tell us about this Nintendo. I've heard of this Nintendo.
Okay, so Nintendo.
They own Mario, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So I just want to say, first and foremost, being a Nintendo fan is pros and cons. Oh, Wii U. It was a bad bandwagon to be on. No one there.
Yeah.
It was very lonely.
Right.
And he stuck it out, man. He has his Wii U.
I turn that thing on every single day.
Nice.
Now, I'm one of the only 11 million to own this thing. Now, the stage for how negative it is before we get into how goddamn positive this is and how fantastic this all is.
You're going to start us low and then bring us up? Okay.
So yeah, and then go low again.
Oh.
Okay. Okay, so first of all, Nintendo announced on their Twitter that there was going to be an announcement for what was the codename NX, which we've heard about almost a year at this point. Very exciting stuff. They announced that with a creepy Mario peeping, an image of Mario peeping through a curtain. No good. Anyway, so we finally get a name, the Nintendo Switch, which, stupid name, but we'll get into that. Okay, so basically what
sounds
it
like
is,
a fetish.
Give me the Switch.
Are you into Nintendo Switch? That's why I dress like Mario.
And I dress like Princess Peach.
I feel like that's where like Zelda dresses Link.
Right.
Anyway.
Whatever you're into. No judgment.
Right. No.
We love here. So imagine kind of like an iPad mini, right? About that size.
Mm-hmm.
With two controllers on the end of it. So basically, at this point, it looks like a big PlayStation Vita. I know. No one else has that either. I know. So it's basically like this big tablet with game controllers on the side. Awesome. So it looks like, you know, just another portable game system. But what it happens is you plug it into like the TV. So there's an actual docking station and it beams directly to the TV. But the way it's supposed to be viewed is it's a console that you take on the go. So basically what it is I get all the Wii U games and all the 3DS games in one package. That's the idea. Mm-hmm. It is a cartridge, is back to the cartridge system, which is good for battery life, which we're going to get into in a minute. Basically, this is, well, at this point, cartridges are more like, they're more akin to like an SD card.
Right, I got you. I'm joking.
Yeah. Yeah, I know, but, you know. You know, you guys don't have the smartest following, I assume.
Oh man! You
know, based on,
wow,
well, based on YouTube.
Good lord!
I would never do that, right, Mike?
No, is my not? I'm trying to screen share, and I don't think it's coming through.
You're screen sharing a big black block is what you're screen sharing.
Oh Jesus, this stupid thing. Okay, I'm working on it. Trying to show pictures, people. Trying to show pictures.
So hold on, man. Ian, now hold on. So you're talking about this two controller. So from what I've seen on online is it's kind of like let's say you have your – here, I'm gonna pull this up on me real quick. So you have your main thing, which is like imagine this, and then you got a controller here, like a controller here, right? And they slide in.
Yeah.
So if you're just holding the controller –
they do. I was getting to that.
We'll do this. Oh, fuck.
No, it completely locks in.
Okay, all right.
And we'll see how durable it is, but at the moment, it's safe to assume no.
Okay.
Yeah. Great to be audio listeners, by the way.
Well, hey. Watch the video.
Okay. So, some more positives. We saw some games. We saw updated version of Mario Kart 8. We saw an updated version of Splatoon. I'm not going to get into how we know it's updated, because that's super fucking nerdy.
Okay.
We got footage of Skyrim, which, and it seems to be Skyrim Special Edition.
But they deny it,
which is all the updated
right?
graphics and everything.
They deny it, right?
No, they don't deny it.
Are they just not admitting
they
to
say
it?
That's not.
Can I?
They're saying it's not actually running, but Bethesda has announced it as an official publishing partner.
Can I jump in here for a second?
Yeah.
I love Skyrim. Skyrim is probably one of my favorite things on the planet. Why on earth is this brand new system that they're coming out with that's all fancy pants, a 7-year-old game? Like, what can't they come up? And I'm not knocking it. I'm just curious. Like, I think that's a really odd choice, don't you?
Yes. Yes and no, because I think what they're trying to say is, because first of all, there's the special edition coming up this year.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So it is in the zeitgeist again. But mostly I think what they're trying to say is, hey, we're going to be in with the third parties again. Like, we're going to have the big games.
Gotcha.
It's more of a statement than it is an announcement.
Gotcha.
They also showed, to that effect, they also showed NBA 2K.
Okay.
And they have a huge list of third-party support. It's pretty great. It was a great graphic. And also, we got footage of a new Mario game, which is big because it's a traditional 3D Mario game, like akin to Mario 64.
All right, there we go. Mike is sharing. Or, he's finally sharing the right thing. Here we go.
Okay.
All right, so keep talking, Ian. I'm sorry.
Okay. What's this he's showing, though? I got to see.
He's showing the Switch and how it works, like the people sitting there playing against each other. And.
Okay. See, it's really cool. Now we're on to the concerns. As you said earlier, there's the two controllers. There's Joy-Con left, Joy-Con right. They act as two separate controllers. That actually joined for one controller, whatever.
Like Voltron?
One of the concerns there. Exactly like Voltron.
It is very Voltronic.
So wait a minute.
Voltron-esque, yes.
So hold on. So if I brought mine over to you, right, to your house, and I was like, hey, let's play some of the... Could I take one of the controllers and you could take the other one? Or is it...
I think it's going to depend. I feel it's going to depend on the game.
Okay.
But here's the thing. We are going off... Most of what we're going off of here is the trailer that they released for the Nintendo Switch.
Yes.
Yes. And they've announced that they're not going to make any more announcements until 2017. So a lot of this is a lot of speculation, but it seems that's going to vary game to game.
I'd like to announce there'll be no more announcements.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, that. Oh, that
by the way, this wonderful game system won't be out for 3 years. Right. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Mic drop.
Boom. Coming in 2025.
Now, I gotta tell you though, it does look pretty cool. I can see why people would be excited about it. I mean,
yeah. Now with the Switch, I heard that there was gonna be a backwards compatible unit that actually fit underneath of it, and it was called the Power Bottom. Did you know anything about that?
Like I said earlier, we're just going off of rumors and speculation at the moment.
Was that the Jenner Switch?
Oh God. All right.
I'm trying to play it off, but I can't. Okay.
Yeah. Don't play it off.
Sometimes you just gotta go with it.
Gotta roll with it.
This is what I used to do to Brian all the time when he did the news.
Yeah. That's the position you're in.
Right.
Is there any other news though, Ian, for any other things coming out, other games or?
Oh yeah. There is. There is, likewise, the same day we also got the Red Dead 2 trailer.
Yes. That looks good. I cannot wait for that. That is awesome.
Anyone who's never played Red Dead, it's basically GTA, you know, Grand Theft Auto, if you know what that means, but it's a Western version of it. And it's awesome because, like, there's kind of cops, but kind of not. I mean, like, it depends. Like, if you're in town, you start, you know, blowing people away. Like, the posse turns on you and everything.
Yeah, they round up a posse for you. Yeah.
Right. But if you go out in the, like, wild, and you're riding down, you come across, like, a group of people, you can just mow them all down and nothing happens to you. There's no cops out there.
Grand Theft Auto 1885. It's awesome.
All right, so I just pulled up the chat room. So, first of all, hi, Mom. And second of all... Derek is in there, and he's saying hi, Ian, and he is so excited about Splatoon being updated as well because
Splatoon update's going to be amazing. Yes.
What's Splatoon? Wait, what is that?
Splatoon is kind of Nintendo shooter.
Okay.
So basically, that is like area control. So you're painting the ground, see who can cover the most ground. Oh, also your squids. It's pretty great.
Oh, I get it.
And you can swim.
Splat. Yeah. I get it. Okay.
Yeah, it's ink, and you're shooting ink everywhere, and you're trying to get the most coverage. Ink.
All right.
Okay. It's very Nickelodeon.
Right. Yes. I got you.
Yeah. Nickelodeon. That's what I was thinking too.
I'm playing the ground there, Mike.
Hold on, and then Derek.
I've seen Japanese porn. I know what they're really talking about.
Squids.
You gave yourself a race, sir.
That's what you call hentai, right? Squids. Yeah. I'm gonna paint the ground.
Derek goes on to say, and people have speculated that you see Mario Kart 9 because it shows Mario holding two power-ups instead of just one.
Yeah, I didn't want to get into that, but yes, there is item switching.
Is that all booze
involved?
Wiki Winks!
Wiki Inks.
Wiki,
well, the Wiki Squid.
Wait a minute. For a plumber, you don't want WikiLeaks.
No. That sounded like groundbreaking information. That was like, it sounded like it came off of WikiLeaks. I didn't know.
Mario!
If the Russians were behind this leak.
Oh, and the smell of bad borscht.
They got nothing else going on.
All right, cool. All right, well, thank you. We're gonna see about having Ian come on from time to time to talk about what's new in video games and such.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
It's been a relatively slow week, so right. But we'll have the two things to really go off of. This is the time where everything's actually coming out finally.
I have to work on his pacing a little bit there, Ian. Though we have to.
Yeah, I noticed.
Pick up the pacing a little bit. All right, so that's fine. You did great.
Very nervous.
That's fine. No, nervous. You're good. Don't be nervous. You're good.
You did great.
All right, so Mike, yes,
I know.
What do we want to do next? Do we want to do a game or do we want to get the? Do you guys want to talk to Magic 8-Bit?
I say let's do a game.
Okay.
And then maybe another game and another game. And then maybe if we do enough games, we won't have to do any Magic 8. Oh, no.
We got to do Magic. No.
I think Mike is scared of Magic 8-Bit.
I really am. Magic 8-Bit scares me.
Its mystical powers are beyond explanation.
I know, right?
No good can come from the Magic 8-Bit.
No. I like Magic 8-Bit. All right. So what do you want to do next?
All right. Let's do a game. Let's do... which game shall we do? I'd like to do let's do my because I have it pulled up here right now. Let's do the Kickstarter or Crapstarter. Now, guys, basically this is going to be a sort of a beta trial. This I had this idea, and I think it's going to work out well. So what we're going to do is I am going to read you the name and description of a Kickstarter that has either failed or it has funded, okay? Now, the player that comes closest to the actual amount without going over, because I think we do need, I've been thinking about this, and we do need to use...
Are we guessing the amount funded or the amount asked? Seems like a basic question, man.
We have to use Price is Right rules, or else everyone can just game theory their way $1 lower or higher. So now there are three things that each of you will be guessing.
Okay.
Ian. It will be the set goal. Okay.
I'm writing.
How much
down.
Did you think that this particular either very pathetic or very ingenious Kickstarter funding wanted? How much was actually pledged, and how many backers there were. So you have three opportunities to score points, okay? And it's not the person that has the most. It's whoever of the three, of your three guesses, whichever one is the closest, that person gets a point. Okay?
Okay.
1 point, Mike?
All right. I'm sorry?
1 point, right?
1 point. Yeah, that's correct. Right. Are you doing a scoring on this for me?
Yep.
I get a 1 point.
I'm doing Jack, Ian, me for this round.
Okay. All right, so this and here's an example, okay? There will be a Kickstarter called Potato Salad, okay?
Oh, my favorite.
Yes. Now, Ian does happen
Can
to
I guess?
This.
Can I guess?
Sure.
$17,000.
How much?
$17,000.
All right, you're guessing $17,000.
Wait, is that the goal or what they're asking for or the backers?
Exactly.
The goal was $10.
Wow.
Goal was $10.
Okay, the goal was $10.
The actual amount was like about $17,000, correct?
You're guessing $17,000, and how many people actually backed it, for example?
Oh, it was a lot. It was a lot.
Okay, give me an example of a lot.
I'm thinking. I'm going to say like $50,000.
Okay, so the goal, as he said, has been dead on for $10. Pledged $55,000. I did one thing wrong with you guys, okay? Here for this particular guy, he said about the project, he said, basically, I'm just making potato salad. I haven't decided what kind. Okay. This guy actually got away with this and it funded for $55,000.
Why am I going to work tomorrow?
Right. I know.
Now, in fairness, he had to put it towards the potato salad.
Listen, yeah.
Had to, was, or what? How do they track that?
Well, you know, that's the
three Blade Runner.
Well, not they don't. Actually.
Look, they don't.
But
I ran a Kickstarter. They don't.
Yeah, he has stretch goals, okay? If it got to $35, he'll make four times as much potato salad, okay? If it got to $100, he will try two different kinds of potato salad recipes.
What?
And once it got really high with the new stretch goals of $1,200, he'll pay someone to film a thank you video for all of my backers, and he did. He actually has a couple of very nice videos on there. I actually recommend you go and look at this Kickstarter. It's kind of cool.
He said, thanks, suckers. I don't have to work next year.
Didn't he also have a potato salad party?
Yes, he did. He had a potato salad party.
Have one hell of a potato salad party.
Oh, he did.
This man's my hero.
Wow.
Yep. Okay. So now that is the that's the example. Okay.
Okay.
So now here is number one. All right.
Number one.
Ready.
Number one is called Game Space Gamer Theory. Smash the game state update. Now, I don't know if you guys know Gamer Theory,
was a book, right? A book about the ideology of video games. So this is a follow-up book, okay? So this guy said, wow, this introduced me to a whole new fascinating world. I predict that the robots will be wrong and that Mr. Spider's Kickstarter campaign will succeed, says Dean Strang. Oh, God damn it, I read the wrong thing. All right, my book is divided into two parts. The first part is a point-by-point response to Mackenzie Wark's excellent gamer theory book in 2007. The second part offers an expanded definition of gamer theory, complete with suggestions and ways the reader may think critically about gaming and such.
Okay.
So,
wow, that's a boring sounding Kickstarter. All right.
Right. So, I will tell you whether something funded or not at the end. Okay. So basically, I need.
What was the name of that thing again?
It was called Game Space. No gamer theory smash.
Hey, no looking it up.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not.
Okay. Yeah, no look up. I can barely use the computer. Are you kidding me?
All right. So again, Ian, what was the or who was it? It's first. It's this one. It's Ian first. Or who's first?
Yeah, Jack. Jack. Sorry, Jack's first.
Yeah.
All right, I'm so on Jack. First. So, what do I think the goal is?
What was the goal he was asking for?
I'm gonna go high. I'm gonna say $1 million.
He wanted $1 million.
Good
okay.
God.
Now what did
let me preface this by saying I've never been on Kickstarter ever.
So. I think you're going to do well at this, Jack. Now, how much was he actually pledged? Did people pledge for his Kickstarter?
I'm going to say like $34.95.
$34.95,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. $34.95. Now, how many backers did he actually get?
Like 12.
12. Okay. Now we're what are we at? Pete?
No, Ian.
Or Ian. Okay, Ian.
Okay. I'm going to say this man's goal was around 5,500.
5,500? Okay.
Yeah.
And he received how much in pledges?
I'm going to say he got like 800.
800.
Bad name.
Okay, 800. And how many backers did he have?
His mom. So one, okay.
One backer. Peter.
All right. Really supportive.
All right, so his goal had to have been, it's a book, had to have been about, I want to say 15,000, but I'm going to say 12,000 was his goal.
Okay.
He was pledged probably about 50 grand. And
okay.
I'm going to say 120 backers.
120 backers. All right. In actuality, this was a failed Kickstarter.
Okay.
His goal was $5,000.
I told you.
His goal was $5,000. Unfortunately, Ian, you were close, but you did.
I know. I know. I went over.
You did go over. He was pledged $590. Again, unfortunately, everyone went over.
Nope. Jack is not over. Jack got the point for that one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, what's up, suckers?
And he had 9 backers.
9 backers. Jack? No, Ian gets the point for that one.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
I was literally closest on every single one.
That's right.
I was closest with everyone, just saying.
You were close, but you did go over. Sorry, buddy. Sorry, buddy.
I get a cigar.
That did sound boring as fuck. No wonder it didn't pass.
Yeah, I know.
I'd like to write a book in response to a book about video games.
Yeah, exactly.
I fell asleep in the middle of that.
I know, right? All right, let's do the next one. Come on, let's keep the pace. Let's keep it going.
Yeah. Here's the next one. Okay. This one is called the Twist Tech iPhone case. The Twist Tech iPhone case, smartest way to carry and protect your iPhone. Clip your phone anywhere and never drop it again. Patent protected design invented by ski instructors, perfect for everyday carry. Now, I'm just going to give you a general description because I don't have my double monitors, so I couldn't have pictures ready. Basically, it's like imagine a clip type of thing, and the phone.
Excuse me.
You can take the phone. Where's my phone?
Don't put your hands between your mouth and the mic.
Sorry. Yep. Yeah. You can take the phone, okay, and you can take it off of the clip, and it rotates like this, and you can look at it, or you can also pull it off and put it back on, and it clips back again. It's very rugged and all that kind of stuff. That's also basically what you have.
Also known as the douche clip. All right, go ahead. Next.
All right.
We'll start with Ian.
That's what you get. Now, Ian, again, need to know how much did they ask for? How much were they pledged, and how many backers?
I think they asked for maybe 20,000.
Okay. A goal of 20,000.
Yeah. I think they maybe got 25.
25,000.
Right?
1,000?
25,000. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And I believe. $500 backers.
Okay.
You know, do the math on that. People believe in it. That each person gave $5,000. All right. Go.
Yeah. They believe in it.
My son has math.
They must. Okay.
They believe in it.
All right.
All right. So I'll go next. What I'm doing is I'm shifting it. So I'll go next. Give Jack a chance to listen to us. All right. So that's going to require two or three molds at about $15,000 a piece.
Shit.
45,000. I think they need about, I'm going to say 50,000.
50,000. Okay. That was the goal. All right.
Yeah. I'm going to say this is a fucking douchey thing that I can see a bunch of tools backing. I'm going to say they made at least, God, they had to have made at least 250,000 off this.
Fuck you. Are you serious? I got to go to this website like right now.
And I'm going to say.
Don't touch your computer. It might update.
I know.
So I'm going to say that people were paying probably about 150 or 100 bucks. Let's say 100. So
oh, my God, dude. This is not engineering. Come on.
So I'm going to say 2,500 backers.
Great. Okay. It was everyone's done, Jack, right? Or no?
No. Jack. Hey, what's up?
Oh, dude, Jack. All right.
Dude. All right, Jack.
Oh, he's going to lose anyway.
All right. So first off, I like how ski instructors invented it as a selling point because we all know how fucking smart ski instructors are and how they are just super geniuses.
Evidently, they drop their phones a lot.
Right. So big selling tech point on that. I'm going to go with they're asking for 20,000. They got 15 backers. And the actual retail price is $4.28.
No, okay. But how much was totally pledged?
$4.28.
Okay.
Because look, you can go to any 7-Eleven and they got 12 different kinds of phone cases in there. Like, who the fuck cares? Do we really need another kind of clip on? Nobody cares.
I like you thinking all this.
But I'm serious.
Okay. Yeah, I hear you, man. That's why I called it a douchey thing. Like, who gives a fuck, right? But whatever. Right. Go ahead, Mike.
All right. Yeah. Okay. This was a failed Kickstarter.
Damn it.
Really?
Because
they had a good name. I thought it was redundant.
As soon as they had it like ready to go, and in the middle of the Kickstarter, they announced the iPhone 6, and it was for the iPhone 5.
Oh, Jesus. You didn't say that would be a factor, you bastard. Man. All right, come on.
It was the only time that happened on these. Anyway, it was a 60,000 goal.
Six, all right. So I was the closest. I got the point for that one.
Pledged was 1,636.
That's Jack.
And 21 backers.
21. That's Jack.
I think that's Jack too. Yep.
Jesus, Jack, you're killing.
Wait. What did you say? What did you say the goal was? You said 70, right?
60,000. No, Pete said it was 50,000. So we got that point.
So I got the point for that one. I was the closest.
Well, I just wanted to check.
Okay. Now. You know how I do shit, Pete. So you got to use your game theory on this, and I am really putting you through the test.
This better be another fucking failed Kickstarter. I'm gonna kick you in the nuts. Hey,
you never know, because with a name like
Smuckers,
gay men draw vaginas.
Oh, that was funded.
A weird and beautiful book of vaginas drawn by gay men. Check out the campaign tab below for more images and our video.
I think I funded that one.
It's a hoot.
Dude, I don't trust a gay man drawing vaginas. I just don't.
I mean, they probably see a lot of them, like, you know, because they're always hanging around chicks. I don't know.
I don't know.
For 3 years, we've been collecting vages drawn by gays, from fine artists to average Joe Homos. The drawings.
Joe Homo. Joe Homo.
The drawings display a range of skill level as to the lay bare the as they lay bare the vagina of the collective gay male mind.
Oh my god, that is so brilliant. You know what?
This one sounds fishy to me.
Many.
Oh, I see what you did there.
I can't even read anymore. Okay, so
let's start the bidding.
The bidding. All right, so I'll go first this time. Fuck. Okay. Goal. It's a book. $7,500.
Is it a coffee table book?
Yes.
That's what I figured.
You put your vaginas on the coffee table.
We want this in paperback. Yeah.
I want the McLovin Dick book. All right. So anyway,
yeah, it's definitely a hardcover.
Yeah. Yeah. It would be
a hard one, dude.
All right. So I'm gonna say
small vagina.
Hey, shut up. $7,500 for my goal.
Uh-huh.
God damn it! Did this one back? Fuck! It had to have, right?
Big time. That bit.
I'm gonna go. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna go 25,000. That it backed, and I'm gonna say 500 backers. All right, that's me. Jack, you're up next.
All right. Well, I'm gonna logically deduce this. First guy, it's about vaginas. Two, women don't care what gay guys think about vaginas, so I don't really know who the target audience for this whole book would be. So I'm gonna say their goal was something lofty. I'll say like 50 grand.
Okay.
I'll say the actual money that they got was $200.
Okay.
And I'll say they had like 4 backers.
All right.
Backers.
Okay. I think this goal was, I'm going to say
65,000.
Okay. 65,000, yeah. I think there's definitely back. I think it may have even gotten. Oh, I didn't mean 65,000. Oh my god, I meant 6,500.
Oh, 6,500.
I mean 6,500.
Okay, that's a factor of 10. That's significant.
Okay.
Yes. I believe it definitely backed for, I'm going to say 75.
Cuz 75,000? 7,500.
Yeah.
Which?
So, 100. My bad.
7,500. Okay. Got it.
And how many backers?
Jeez. Okay.
Or fronters? I don't know why they're backers because they're
remember.
I'm gonna say like, I'm doing the math this time.
Okay.
Oh.
75 people. That'd be 100 apiece.
Yeah. I'm thinking up to 100, around 100. Yeah, 100. 100. Okay. Lock it in.
Hey, so just remember,
there's no
guys.
Way this didn't back.
Just remember, guys. This is a book about vajayjay by the gay. All right, anyway, Mike, go ahead.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, gay men drawing vaginas. Oh, it funded.
Okay.
It funded. The goal was $37,000.
All right, so hold on. 37. Shit. All right, so that's me.
I think that's you, yep. Pledged was $61,000.
That's me again.
Yeah, 61,706 to be exact. Nice. And the backers were the people that fronted the vagina book is 1,000.
That's me again.
And 58.
Yes, I nailed this one. I wasn't as close as I could have been, but I got the points.
You would nail the vagina book.
That's it, man.
The gay vagina book.
I have a whole list of these, but I would really like to do this next one. And I think we'll do it at 4. We'll cap this at a 4. For
another one? Okay.
I need this one, okay? This one, fuck. Trust me, all right. You need this.
Hold on. I said, damn it. I thought we were only doing 3. All right, so go.
You destroyed Pete's planning. Good job.
Go, pledge.
Maybe I can get another point. So you can get 2 points.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right, people. This next one. Oh, God, this is going to be great.
All right, come on.
Doubt it.
It's called Grilled Jesus. Grilled Cheeses, rather. I'm sorry. Grilled Cheeses.
Oh, yeah, I know this one.
Okay, first of all, let me just see your game theory. You may know it.
But use your game theory here and your strategy, because you want to just act like you know what it is. Maybe it funded, maybe it didn't, but do you want your competitors to know this? That being said, your prayers have been answered.
Feast, I'm here to entertain.
Feast on the goodness of everybody loves G's. Oh, God damn it. Your prayers have been answered. Feast on the goodness. Everybody loves cheese. Please come support us on Kickstarter. Thank you for coming to support Grilled Cheeses. What started a few years ago as a fun idea is on the verge of being realized.
Oh, my God.
The Grilled Jesus is basically, it looks like a, what is that thing called? One of those, oh, God. Who's the dude that made the fighter, the grill, George Foreman grill.
Okay,
thing.
All right, God, all right, sorry.
That was a good one.
I burned that one. It's like a George Foreman grill. Shut up. It's like a George Foreman grill, but it has the it basically impresses the Jesus toasting on the cheese.
Gosh.
On the Who doesn't
panini
need that?
Press. Nah, I don't.
I know some people who like that. You know what, yo? I could go down to ghetto and sell a ton of those, man.
I'd like to get one, make a grilled cheese sandwich, and then sell it on Kickstarter as some kind of miracle. That would be the
yes.
Well, you know,
Is that how Kickstarter works?
Didn't somebody get like $2 million for a fucking piece of toast on eBay that was Jesus burnt or something?
Yeah, that's what.
I think that's, you know, hey, everyone has an idea. All right,
come on, let's get on.
So it's a sandwich press that toasts the face of Jesus into every sandwich bread.
All right, we're starting with Ian.
Ah, shit. Okay. I'm gonna say.
How much did they ask for?
100,000.
Wow.
100,000. Wow. Nice.
That's okay. A lot of grilled cheese.
I mean, they're preaching the Lord. They're preaching the word of Christ. You know, they can ask whatever they want. It's extortion.
God is good.
But
God is great.
But grilled Jesus is better.
No. I think this funded just based on the pun alone. I'm pretty sure the internet went crazy for this one. So I'm going to say funded for 110,000 to be safe.
Okay.
Backers, I don't know, 700.
Okay. All right, I'm next. Right.
Ian's balls in on grilled cheeses.
All right, so.
Are you not balls deep in Christ?
Again, we got molds. We got electronic boards. We got. Yeah, I think Ian was pretty close to 100,000. I'm probably going to need somewhere around there. So I'm going to go 120. Now, you know. 80. I'll go 80.
Remember the potato salad, people. That's all I'm going to say.
I'm going to go 80. I'm going to say this motherfucker made 250,000 because I just want to punch him in the nuts because of it. And I'm going to say there were 2,000 backers. Jack.
All right.
All right. I think what they should do is get a machine that does the drawn vaginas on the sandwich, because that would be much more interesting.
Oh, you are. I think Pete did a spit take.
Vaginas.
Gay drawn vagina sandwiches, I think, would be the way to go.
Grilled vagina.
And then you can throw a little tuna in there. Oh, that would be delightful.
Ooh, tuna mutton. Melt.
Yes, tuna melt with gay drawn vaginas. Boom. Kickstarter, here I come.
Wow. Now you're shipping your Kickstarters.
Guys,
that's awesome.
You actually have a best of real cheese.
God, you right. Just combine like the potato salad, the Jesus, and the vagina book all in one.
Yeah. There's a. Oh my God.
Notice how you skipped over that fucking book.
I was thinking too earlier when we were talking about the vagina book. Like, you could do the opposite and have like camel toes on fat guys. You know, fat guys, sometimes it looks like they got a camel toe.
It's a moose knuckle.
Yeah, Dad.
Right. You could do a book on those. Don't you, Dad? Like, having women draw those.
Drawn by lesbians.
Right. Yes. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Oh, a book of cocks drawn by lesbians?
That would be awesome.
That would be.
All right. So, anyway.
I would buy that.
I'm going to go big on cheeses. I really am. I'm going to say the goal was lofty and lordlike at 500,000.
Lofty and lordlike.
Lordly and lofty. I'm going to do the actual retail price. I think that Jesus freaks love this kind of shit, and they go nuts for it. I really do. They love this kind of horse shit. I'm going to say they got $300,000.
So, wait a minute. Are you saying it backed or not? Because you got to go over 500 if you backed.
Yeah, it backed. All right. Well, I don't know how this shit works. I'm, you know. Okay. You're lucky I'm even on this little cube here.
Right.
What? I'll say it backed at 500, and I'll say it had like 300 plus backers.
All right. You want to say more than that?
Yeah.
If it was 500, that'd be 1,000 apiece.
All right, we'll do.
No, they're just really committed.
We'll do 1,500.
1,500. All right, that sounds reasonable.
1,500.
All right. I have to put Jack out because he hasn't done the Kickstarter. So you know, come on.
Is
that everyone? Tiny. Yeah, we're good.
All right.
A little handicapped. All right,
please,
shit.
Please, enlighten us with the cheesy.
Well,
cheesy goodness.
Grilled Jesus did fund. But Jesus, you guys like totally went all. I think all of you are like off the board.
Right.
The goal was only $25,000.
25. So we're all over. What? So none of us get a point for that.
And okay. It just funded at $25,604.
God damn it! All right, none of us got the point for that.
And did anyone say any less than 286 backers?
Yes, Ian got the point for that.
All right.
All right. So, final score. Let me tally.
I'll take the point just because I'm already losing. But
no, you
sure
got it. No,
that.
You don't have to take it. You got it. So, let's see. Jack, you got 1, 2, 3. You got 3. So, Jack has 3. Ian, you have
1, 2.
And then I have 4. So, I win this one, Mike. But
wow!
But Jack gave me a fighting. I mean, Jack did well, man. He got 3 points.
This game's rigged.
No,
just
Jack.
Like the election.
Hold on,
it's
wait.
Rigged.
Jack, you came in second place. You've never even fucking heard
of
Kickstarter.
Yeah, No, I've heard of it. I've never been. Oh, I've never checked. Okay. I've never looked at it.
It's awesome. Wow. Well, you know, there is a serious handicap in this, in that I'm a fucking Kickstarter nut. So I've done a bunch of I've done a Kickstarter. I've backed a bunch of Kickstarters. We interview fucking Kickstarter people all the time. I should have like blown the shit out of you guys, but
yeah, but you know, it's hard to overthink this stuff, you know.
Oh, it is. And Kickstarter is that way. Like, you don't know what the fuck is gonna hit. It's like internet memes. It's like somebody put some shit up and like Steve Wallet, right? He's done 4 Kickstarters, 3 of which have not funded, and the one that did fund, he got like $15,000 for it.
Yep.
So it's like, bruh. You know, and the second one, so he did a book, he did a drink book, that made $15,000. He did a sequel to that drink book, it made almost nothing. Like, what the fuck? Same guy making the same kind of book, nothing.
Right.
So it's weird, man. It's a crap.
Finding in a bottle.
Yep. Yep.
That's
all right. So that was a good game, Mike. I think it needs a little tiny little bit of refinement, but good game. I like it.
I liked it too.
Yeah,
it was good.
All right,
thanks,
so.
Guys.
Fine.
Let's do Bet the Geek next. We're gonna put Jack on the spot.
Woo!
Put Jack up on the vagina.
Right. On the hot cheesy vagina.
Guys, I think you just ruined sex.
Oh no! Don't say that.
What do you know?
I don't know.
Yeah, he doesn't know.
He doesn't know. Grandma.
How about
doesn't
we
know
get
anything.
A book of Ian drawing vaginas?
Oh shit, Grandma Stephanie.
Grandma's on there.
Hi, Grandma.
Yeah. Hey, you kiss your grandmother with that mouth?
Grandma.
Very incrementally.
Very incremental.
All right. All right, you guys, you ready to play Bet the Geek?
Yes.
All right. So, Jack, you are our geek this week. So, here's what's going to happen. Welcome to the game time. Welcome to Game Time with the MythWits. I'm your game master, Michael Cthulhu Kafes, and we are going to play Bet the Geek. For this episode, we've taken Star Wars questions directly out of Studio 187's Cube of Death role-playing trivia game. Jack, you are our geek tonight, and we are going to bet on how well you know Star Wars.
All right.
Panelists, that's Pete and Ian. I will ask you.
And you, Mike.
I will ask. Yes. Oh, that's right, too. I get to play.
Yeah, yep.
I will ask Jack a trivia question. He will write down the answer, and I will lock it in. Then we'll go around the room and ask each player in turn whether Jack got the answer correct or if he got it wrong. You will also hedge your bets by betting 1, 2, or 3 points based on how confident you are in Jack's geek foo, his Star Wars foo. And there will be a total of 4 questions, and each player will start with 10 points. Pete will be the manning the scoreboard and will update us at the end of each round. Good luck,
everybody.
It is now time to bet the geek.
Oh, was I supposed to chime in?
No.
Okay. I don't know if it's a real portion.
All right. Jack?
Yes.
You're right. It's addictive. Pete.
Jack?
He used to always go, Mike? Anyway, question number 1, Jack.
Now, we're not betting on this one. This is just to see how Jack knows. How well Jack knows.
Okay. So these are the test questions. Okay. Okay. So these are kind of softballs, but we're going to get an idea of what you know. All right.
Okay.
So who owned the Millennium Falcon before Han Solo?
Ooh, I believe that would be Lando Calrissian.
Ooh, he even pronounced it correctly.
Very good.
Now, I thought there was also a Colt 45 on the table for this bet, right?
It works every time.
I shouldn't get that reference.
Question number 2. What was Luke Skywalker's name in the early drafts of Star Wars?
It was Luke Starkiller.
Oh shit. This is the real deal. Very good. Okay. Question number 3. What is the official name of the Death Star's planet destroying weapon? The official name.
Oh, he ain't gonna know that shit.
The big gun.
That's a hard question.
That's a big fucking gun. And no, it is not. Okay. The answer is Conclave Dish Composite Beam Super
Shut
Laser.
Shut the fuck up.
No, I gotta write that down.
It's a super easy, a medium hard, and a really hard question. We're just trying to gauge how well you know Star Wars.
Okay.
That's all.
Conclave.
That was an engineer type question, by the way, just for the record.
A concave super engineers.
I know.
Certainly, Jack.
All right, so Jack, now we're into the game. Now this is where your balls are on the line.
Ooh.
The line drawn by a vagina. No, oh my god. How about armless ladies drawing penises with their vagina?
Yeah, I don't know.
You're reaching.
Now that's a book right there. That is a book.
That's a messy something. Book.
It's a coffee table book. Okay, here we go. Question number 1.
Remember, everyone, you don't need to know the answer. You're betting on whether Jack will know the answer. And Jack, don't answer these until after we all bet. Okay, just making sure.
I can bet up to 4, right?
Right.
3. Yeah. 1, 2,
Let's
or 3.
Let's go.
Okay, 3. Thank you.
Okay. So here's the we'll do the question. Jack will lock in his answer, then we will go around and say if he's going to get it right or not, and then he will reveal. Here we go. In episode 4, where was Luke going to pick up power converters? In episode 4, where was Luke going to pick up power converters?
All right, we're going to start with you, Mike. You're first on my list.
Let's see. That's a difficult one. I'm going to say, and you know, it's just really weird. I'm going to bet against him. I'm going to bet 1 point against him that he gets it wrong, but I'm rooting that he gets this right.
I got
so
you.
That's
all right, right. So 1 is no. All right. I'm second on this list. See, I don't think this is a hard one. I think this is actually an easy one. So I'm going to say 2 that he gets it right. Ian?
Yeah, I'm thinking 2 he gets it right, because that's like entry-level Star Wars nerddom. Okay. That's kind of like knowing Salacious Crumb, the same.
Wow, maybe I'm just that bad. I'm like, I never heard that place. Okay, so Jack?
Yes.
Where was Luke going to pick up power converters?
He was going to Tashi to pick up some power converters, and then you can waste time with your friends when your chores are done.
Nice!
Oh, you're my hero. I love nice. You. Oh,
I'm sorry. It's Tashi Station. It's like, I'm just kidding.
Nice. There you go.
Well, all right. All right. All right. That's it. That's it. That you're my golden boy. I'm not bending against you again.
I'm telling you, dude. I don't know much, but I know this shit. Let's go.
Hey, that's why I geared this game to you, Jack.
Jack said, let's go. All right. Question number two. This rogue squadron leader is the only pilot to survive both Death Star runs. This rogue squadron leader is the only pilot to survive both Death Star runs. Now, I am going to say that he gets it right for 3 points.
Okay. And I'm gonna say that he gets it right for 2 points. Ian?
I'm saying he gets it right for 3 points. There's no way he gets that wrong. There's no way he gets Tashi and gets this wrong.
Okay.
Thank you, Ian.
All right.
Jack?
I was perplexed by this question.
Uh-oh.
But I think it's Luke Skywalker.
Oh, shit.
Oh!
God damn. Did you do that shit on purpose?
Is it that weird little, like, whiny guy that says he can, is ready to take on the whole empire himself?
Wedge Antilles.
Yeah. Yeah, is that him?
Yeah, that's him. Yeah.
I thought it might be him.
I had faith in you, man.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry to let you down.
Did me wrong, Jack.
All right.
That's why it's a game.
That's Dummy why it's a dirty. Game. Yep. Hey, let's do a roundup real quick. Currently, Mike, you're at 6. I'm at 10. Ian, you're at 9. Still anybody's game.
All right, Jack. All right, Jack. Question number 3.
Yes.
How do sand people hide their numbers?
Ah. No.
How do sand people hide their numbers?
Mike?
In paper bags. Jesus
Christ. Behind the cabbage.
Again, I'm going 3. You know it. You have to know this. If you don't, that's it. If you don't get this right, I am betting against you on everything. I don't care if it's what is Luke Skywalker's name.
Right. All right. Mike, I'm going to agree with you. I think he's got to know this one. Got to. So I'm going 3, yes.
Game theories.
You burned me before. Buddy.
You could pull ahead.
You burned me before. 3. We're going 3. He gets it right.
3, yes. All right. All right, Jack. Oh, here we go.
These tracks are single file. Sand people move in paths to hide their numbers.
Yep.
That is correct. That is correct, sir.
All right. All right.
All right, all right, all right. I love that. He actually had to put his hood up on that one for the audio listeners.
That was good. Nice effect.
Thank you.
Almost as good as Dark Clicks.
Darth, I was getting ready to say Darth Blix might have a little
competition there.
Yeah. Competition there. All right. All right. Are we ready for question number 4?
We're ready.
Lay it on me.
Okay. I don't have to declare that this is a double or nothing in the beginning, right? Or I just,
no, you don't have to. You shouldn't have. But that's
I
okay.
shouldn't have. Yeah. Okay. Good.
That's
good.
Right. Doesn't matter.
Question number 4. Who is the Baron Administrator on Cloud City? Who is the Baron Administrator shit. On Cloud City?
I see the dude's face in my head, too.
Yeah.
We need music for this part.
Who? Who is the Baron?
I'll record something for you guys.
Administrator on Cloud City. This is a really good question, Pete.
Yeah, you like that?
You got that right.
Yeah, I think that's a good tough one.
Okay, so this is a double or nothing. He has to be actually, because how does this work, Pete, with the double or nothings? when we do this live.
We bet.
Right.
He does not reveal.
And then we do the bet again. Okay. Yeah. All right. So do you have an answer locked in? Jack?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Okay. Mike?
So now this is a double or nothing question, Jack.
Okay.
So
wait a minute. No. Go around the room.
Oh, I'm sorry. Jesus. I'm going to bet one that he gets it right.
Okay. I'm going to say two that he gets it wrong.
I'm going three. He gets it wrong. It's not your fault. That's just a really obscure question.
I think that's
obscure.
Okay. All right. So now for double or nothing, Mike.
All right. Double or nothing. Who is his chief administrative aide?
That guy with the male pattern baldness like robot machine that comes around to his ears and blinks. I think his name is Rogaine Decepticon is his name.
All right. So I guess we've just burned the double or the nothing.
Skip the double or nothing. It doesn't matter. Just go with. All right. So everybody's locked in.
Is Rogaine Decepticon wrong?
It is wrong.
Oh.
So just do the reveal. Jack, who is the Baron Administrator on Classic?
I have no fucking clue.
No clue. All right. So, Mike, you're down a point.
I described him. That should count for something.
No.
You did not.
The Baron Administrator on Cloud City. Who was the, a Baron Administrator?
Is it Lando?
Yes.
That's Lando.
Lando. That was his title.
That was ridiculous. That was his... And two questions where Lando's the answer?
No.
Come on.
No.
Come on.
No, listen. No, the answer to the second one is chief administrative aide was Lobot. And that is the ball pattern guy with the thing on his head and the.
Oh man, I love Lobot.
Lobot.
Lobot's the dude, man.
I've always wanted to go for him as Chris for Halloween.
Right. Yeah, me too, with the bald head and everything. All right, yeah. So
that's the iPhone 8.
Because the double or nothing got a little blown.
It's not a double or nothing. It's just
we have a tie.
What?
Oh. We have a tie. Me and Ian both have 15.
All right.
Yeah.
Give me 1 second. I can whip up a question in 3, 2.
Whose name is 1. Chewbacca?
-1, -2. Where's my fucking deck? Oh, that's right.
In Force Awakens, what awakens?
My nuts. Mike, you got it? Or what's going on?
Yeah. I have to run through this quiz real quick. All right.
Oh, you're pulling up online?
What's the name of the book that Yoda wrote where he drew vaginas?
Okay. Here's a worthy one, okay?
All right.
What is the actual name of the cantina where Obi-Wan and Luke met Han and Chewie?
Oh shit, I don't know.
All right.
Dude, that's a really okay.
I'm an idiot then.
I don't like that one.
Yeah, that's a tough one, dude.
Dude, that's way too tough to fucking be a tiebreaker. This is why we plan shit out. All right. Go to a different one. That's too tough for a tiebreaker, because me and Ian are both going to say 3 no, and we're going to get the same score.
Okay.
Yeah, Dad, I don't even know that one, man.
Nobody knows that one.
Yeah, I know.
All right, how about this one? What is the full name of Luke's gunner during the Hoth battle?
All right, there we go.
Oh, that's a good one.
Full name?
Or no. You know what? I think we realized that we were going to just take the first name. We can take the first name of it.
All right. First names. That's better. All right. First name. Let us know when you're locked in, Jack D.
I'm locked.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to say that he knows. Oh, it doesn't matter. You guys are the tiebreaker.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what you
Yeah, guys. Nobody cares.
Nobody cares. That's normal.
I'm going to say... I'm going to go 3 that he knows it.
Well, I guess in the interest of making it go by faster, 3 he doesn't know it.
Okay. Hey, you might win.
Even though I'm pretty sure he knows it.
All right.
Yeah.
Shall I reveal?
Yes.
Dak.
Dak. Yay, I lose.
Yay, that's correct.
That is correct. And
yeah, Ian, I beat you so bad. No, so
oh man.
And
what are you doing? Oh, wait, are you trying to play the theme music?
Yeah, and I don't have it.
Of course not. All right, da, Mike, unprepared as usual.
Hey, come on, man. I'm dealing with one monitor, man.
I know. All right. All right, so I won that one. Thanks, Ian, for taking the bullet on that one because we both knew how that was going to go. Let's do. Want to do MatchWits and then 8-bit, or do you want to do 8-bit and then MatchWits?
We're all okay to run long then, right? It doesn't matter because we're just going to record these. Okay, all right.
I can do one more.
You know what? I'm dying. I am just literally dying. For 8-bit.
All right. Yay, me too. All right. And you're hearing this, right? You're hearing this?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, good. All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool.
All right. So I put it on me. So we were talking to Mike and I, and Jack were talking earlier, and Mike and Jack were and I were talking about the election and stuff, and Mike and Jack were had concerns about you know, about this election. I mean, it's fucking up in the air. It's this crazy, craziest election I can remember.
Yes, and I have concerns about talking about the election. I'm really scared about it.
Right. Yep. Don't worry. We're not a political show.
But the reason that I agreed to do this is because we are asking an inanimate, artificially intelligent being. So I figure that, you know, it's okay that, you know, that if whatever its opinion is, isn't, you know, biased from human.
It's not a human.
Human input.
It's not a human, Mike.
That's what I'm saying.
Right.
I just said it's an artificial not intelligence. It's not prone to human.
A human would not come up with these answers. It's completely a robot thing.
Right.
Artificial intelligence.
It's a brobot.
So Mike, what did you want to ask Magic 8-Bit?
Well, first of all, I mean, you're the one who has been pressing us, like, hey, we should ask the Magic 8-Ball a bunch of questions about the election and stuff. And my first question would be that, is the Magic 8-Bit going to even vote in the elections in November?
Damn, probably doesn't have an ID.
I don't know. Do you think they'll? Well, that doesn't seem to matter. depending on who you ask. All right. I don't know. Hey, Magic 8-Bit, what do you think of that?
I do not want to see that in a book.
Do you think it looks like a USB port?
Oh, was it drawn by a gay robot?
I know. I think it looks.
Was it drawn by C-3PO?
I don't know.
Oh, God.
Jack, why don't you ask a question? You think you know so much.
I'm concerned that people aren't going to accept whoever is you know, actually makes it in. That there's going to either side is going to get nutty. Right. What does the Magic 8-Ball think is going to? Is there going to be any kind of crazy? Are people going to accept?
Fuck. That's a good question, Jack. Yeah, because that's mm-hmm. a concern. All right, let's see. Magic 8-Bit, what do you think? God.
Wow.
No, that was Jack, Magic 8-Bit. That was Jack that asked that question. I know Mike usually talks to you, but that was Jack.
And what do her polyps look like if her vagina looks like a like a USB port?
Light bulbs.
I don't know. Like a capacitor.
And nice LED strip.
Right. LED polyps.
So, well, I can see them.
Speaking of LED polyps, Magic 8-Bit. Do you think Hillary will finally forgive Bill Clinton for his indiscretions while he was in office?
Ooh, that's a good one. That's a good one. All right, let's see.
What?
What do the Tic Tacs have to do with it?
You'll learn.
Maybe that's what her polyps look like.
You gotta have
like Tic Tacs. That wasn't Tic Tacs, Magic 8-Bit. Those ain't Tic Tacs.
Oh God. Jack.
Yeah. Trump says he's going to bring in the best people. The biggest people, the best people. You're going to love it. It's wonderful. It's going to be great.
It's going to be huge.
People. There's going to be huge people, the best people, only the best people, all winners, all big league people. Do you think Magic 8-Ball or whatever Pete calls you is going to do you think that's going to come true? Do you think he's going to pick the best people?
I don't know. Let's see.
Very true. Very true.
Man, Magic 8-Bit's on fire tonight.
I'm telling you.
Hold on. This is the thing that's pissing me off. First of all, everyone's thinking like it's only down between Hillary and Trump, but I mean, you know, there is the Libertarian Party here, and I'm just wondering. True. I mean, you know, do you think that
my dude Gary Johnson,
Magic 8-Bit? Do you think that the Libertarian Party is ready to face the challenges of the highest position in the land?
Oh man, that's a good question
because he supports marijuana,
right? Yeah, smoking a gosh, right? Let's see. So, Magic 8-Bit, what do you think about that?
Oh,
Magic 8-Bit, that is a low blow.
Johnson's my man.
What do you think Magic 8-Bit's favorite foreign leader is?
Bobby has no idea.
Hey, has Magic 8-Bit climbed Mount Everest?
I don't think so.
Magic 8-Bit the governor of Arizona? I don't think so.
Nope.
Did she do 12 bong hits before the Today Show?
Right. Name another candidate who could do like 10 bong hits and climb Mount Everest. I mean, you know?
It's very true.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I feel like Trump does that with cocaine, though.
Yeah, he's like, what?
Thank you.
All right. So, any more questions, you guys? You got anything else going on there?
I want to know if Magic 8-Bit thinks that if the DNC cheated Bernie Sanders.
Oh, DNC, okay, let's see. Low blow. Jesus. Poor Hillary.
This bitch is bitter.
You know who's crazy, though, is that Jill Stein. Mm-hmm. Like, she's spray painting bulldozers, and she's against vaccinations.
Right.
And she thinks that, you know, she thinks that Monsanto is going to poison your sperm and everything.
Right.
What do you think her odds are of getting it?
Oh, that's a good question. You think Magic 8-Bit has an insight on this, huh? So let's see. Magic 8-Bit, what do you think? Jill Stein, any chances? Oh, God.
Oh, wow. So there's millions of people in the Midwest that believe? Is that what that says? Yes.
God.
Jeez.
What about Ted Cruz? She's got to have an opinion on old Ted Cruz.
Oh, Ted Cruz. Oh, God. Ted Cruz. Right. Okay. All right. Ted Cruz, what do you think? What do you think of that, Magic 8-Bit? You think, they'll write in Ted Cruz, maybe? Maybe?
Oh, wow.
First of all, I don't think they're peanuts. I think they're Tic Tacs.
Yeah, I think we've established that, right?
Where does this shit come out? First, I mean.
Yeah, that's.
You know what? Never mind.
Capacitor. I'd assume.
2 8-bits, one cup.
Don't ruin the flux capacitor, man. 2 8-bits, one cup.
Any more?
But wait a minute. 2 8-bits. Is that 16 bits? I don't know. I mean,
what
I've
does
seen
that 8-bit the, think of all the. Oh, my bad.
I've seen the candidates carrying copies of the Constitution around like everywhere they go. Would you like to see Trump and Hillary do that?
Oh, okay. Yeah, I've seen that. Yeah, a couple guys carrying it around. Yeah, let's see.
Very good. Very good.
Yeah, it hurts because you know.
I know.
That hurts. Right. I wanted the Galaxy Note 7, and it doesn't exist anymore.
No.
It's the only product that has turned into vaporware.
Literally. Like, literally. Yeah. Like, yeah. Smoking vaporware. All right.
Saving it in the cloud. Smoke.
Any more? Any more?
Well, I think just to wrap it up, really, okay. Like, what does Magic 8-Bit think of the entire process as a whole? Like, the entire cycle that we've been on for the last 2 years? Oof. Sum it all up.
Okay.
What is
it? Magic 8-Bit, what do you think?
So.
Very true.
Very true. That's
exactly right.
Hey, wait a minute. She has a dog?
Yes.
Is it canine?
It's yeah. Well, I was gonna say it's a digi. Yeah, master. All right. All right. I think Magic 8-Bit's getting a little punchy. I think that's
you
enough.
You think?
Yeah.
I think after the first question, she got punchy.
Yeah. She's definitely got an attitude.
Right.
I'm telling you.
A bit of a bitch.
We need to get her laid.
Yeah.
Your C-3PO is interested.
No, he's not.
No, he's not.
He draws vaginas, remember?
That's right. R2-D2
is the fastest gay man I know.
He's jerking off the Bender.
Oh, God. I don't think Bender's his type.
No. Well, Bender's definitely a type.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But I think Bender would hit just about anything.
Yeah, but I don't. I'm saying I don't think C-3PO would go for Bender. I think he's a little too bad boy, you know?
A little? Oh,
yeah. He'd be into the Nintendo Power Bottom for sure.
Oh, probably. Shit.
What?
Hold on. Let me see something here. What the fuck? They're saying that they couldn't hear the responses in the chat room. Son of a bitch. Seriously?
Oh.
Don't. You're killing me here. You know what it is? I think it's because I'm going to check something real quick. Mike, get ready for the next game.
And that's fine because you know what? You should still have your local recording.
I do. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. I can always insert them too. No, I think – remember I told you I had to uninstall VoiceMeter and reinstall it?
Yes.
How much you want to bet that dicked me?
I will bet 3 points that it definitely dicked you.
Hey guys, I gotta run.
Okay.
All right, Ian.
Bye.
Take care, buddy.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Thank you for your video game report.
All right. Yeah. Thanks a lot. Yeah,
of course. Sorry about that again.
No, it's fine. No, you did fine. You did fine. That's fine.
Kawaii.
All right, man. See you later. Shit. Where the fuck is it? There's a setting. I just want to check real quick while I got it here. Device. Auxiliary output. Why is it not? I don't know. I should have been recording. Oh, well, anyway, I'll check it out later. I don't know. Like I said, VoiceMeter was having a shit fit with me, and I had to reinstall it, and I wouldn't be surprised if it didn't screw up the whole sound thing. Anyway, that's fine. We'll figure it out.
Alrighty then. So let's see if we can actually do one of these games in a semi-professional manner. You want to try that?
Yeah.
Yes,
I do.
All right.
We've only got one more. We've got one more left.
Third time's the charm. Here we go.
Unfortunately, Ian left. MatchWits works better with more people, but we'll make it work.
Oh, shit. That's true.
It's the game that actually works with extra people. So
thanks, right, buddy.
I didn't know he had to go early. Okay. All right, let's do it.
Yeah, I'll bet you he had to go because he's in his room and his brother has to sleep and blah, blah, blah.
Whatever. Roll.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. Welcome to Game Time with the MythWits. I'm your game master, Michael Cthulhu Kafes. We are going to play MatchWits, the game where we try really hard to fill each other's blanks. I will read a question in which you will be asked to fill in the blank. Fill in the missing blank with any word but blank. After everyone has locked in their answer, you will all bare your blanks to the camera. Every matching
pen and paper.
Say what?
Do I need pen and paper for this again?
Yes, this is a pen and paper. It doesn't matter. You know
it
what?
It doesn't matter. We can go. It doesn't matter.
You have a trust. You have a trustworthy face, and there's only two of you. So what the fuck? Beep, okay. So basically, every matching panelist that matches a blank will be awarded $500,000, and every time you tickle my funny bone, you will be awarded a scale of 1 to 100,000 points. Every time you tickle my funny bone every time you kick my funny bone in the nuts, I will penalize you 1 to 100,000 points. So basically, you can get just as many points or some points for being funny. But, you know, just don't try and be funny, whatever you do.
Don't do that. That's
Don't be funny.
Right. All right, let's go.
All right, here we go. And we're doing three. This is going to be a three rounds, all right? We're going to get this three up and three down.
Let's go.
All right. Sulu was having a difficult time. Still at his station.
Sitting still.
When Oh, Jesus Christ.
It's important, dude.
You wrote this book here. All right. Sulu was having a difficult time sitting at his station. When Captain Kirk asked him about it, he confided in him that back was sore from blank. Sulu was having a difficult time sitting at his station. When Captain Kirk asked him about it, he confided in him that his back was sore from blank.
And we can only use one word?
No, you can use whatever. You can make a whole,
you can
doesn't
use
matter.
A small little phrase, but you know, think about something that Pete would say and or I would say. I guess I'll play in this one too. Sulu was having a difficult time sitting still at his station. When Captain Kirk asked him about it, he confided him that his back was sore from... All right, I am locked in.
All right,
I'm locked. Jack, are you locked in?
Sure. Am I supposed to? So I'm just supposed to answer this question with what's in the blank?
That is correct. Wait, after okay. I read this question for you.
Yes.
Pardon me. All right, Jack, you'll go first. Sulu was having a difficult time sitting at his station. When Captain Kirk asked him about it, he confided in him that his back was sore from blank.
Hunching over drawing vaginas.
Very good one. Very good. Very good.
I am working on a book.
Working on a book.
Oh my. Peter, why was Sulu still why was his back so sore?
Wait a minute, he ran out of ink trying to draw Uhura's giant. Oh, never mind. All right. I said Scotty's man meat.
Ooh.
All right.
Yes.
And I said that he was polishing tribbles.
Oh god.
Ooh, nice. Nice. So
is that a euphemism?
That is definitely a euphemism on the Enterprise. All right. Well, no matches so far, gentlemen, but definitely some Sulu-worthy answers. All right, here we go. Number two. Dr. McCoy loves spicy food, but one bowl of hot Klingon guinea worms sent him running for blank. Dr. McCoy loves spicy food, but one bowl of hot Klingon guinea worms sent him running for blank. Dr. McCoy loves his spicy food. But one bowl of hot Klingon guinea worms sent him running for...
All right, I'm locked in.
You good, Jack?
Yeah, yep.
All right, Dr. McCoy loves spicy food, but one bowl of hot Klingon guinea worms sent him running for blank.
The recipe.
Recipe, okay. Recipe.
I thought my answer was going to be bad. I mean, my answer is worse. Peter.
I said,
where was the Dr. McCoy running for?
I said transporter number 2.
Oh.
God damn, that's a good one. I was going to say transporter, but I didn't think of number 2. So I just said, because I could not think of anything. I was like, I said sick bay, which is, yeah, I know.
Hey, I don't get any points for being funny. No funny bone. No funny bone points.
Yeah, you know what? You do. You get half a point.
Half a point. All right, good. Yeah. Might win. That's a 0.5.
You might win this by half a point. All right.
I'll take it.
Okay. All right. Kirk and Spock. Actually, you know what? Jack gets a whole point. I forgot to award him a whole point for his when Sulu was bent over drawing vaginas.
Fair enough.
Okay. It's definitely
that was twice as good as transporting.
I like when I'm suddenly winning. That's great.
Great no problem. This is a good game, isn't it? Okay. Kirk and Spock were trapped together in a holding cell when Spock suddenly succumbed to Ponfar. Kirk's blank will never be the same. Kirk and Spock were trapped together in a holding cell when Spock suddenly succumbed to Ponfar. Kirk's blank will never be the same. There's so many answers.
Yeah. Okay.
One blank.
Two answers, one blank. All right.
Kirk and Spock were trapped together in a holding cell when Spock suddenly succumbed to Ponfar. Kirk's blank will never be the same.
Jack?
I'm going to say Kirk's phaser is never quite the same.
Ooh, his phaser. Permanently set to stun.
Permanently stunned.
Yes.
Mike, I hate to sound like an echo. Go ahead, read the question.
Kirk and Spock were trapped together in a holding cell when Spock suddenly succumbed to Ponfar. Kirk's blank will never be the same.
Transporter number 2.
Jesus Christ. Always with the number 2.
I heard Spock is pretty big.
So I am too legit right now. This is really funny. I wrote down one answer, and then I had a second, and this was totally when the music was playing. And I wrote down a second answer, and I even, you know, wrapped my pen around it. So at first I just went with straight out anus, but I think my camera might be reversed. I don't know if
phaser!
You guys can see this.
Yep.
But I said phaser. So,
you bastard.
Yep. Yep.
That's one
and
does that mean we win, Mike?
That means that you win by 1 point.
Yeah!
Yes. Jack wins with 500,001 points. Mike, you're in second place. Wait a minute. Mike, you're in second place with 500,000 points. And I'm in third place with 0.5. Half a point. One half. That's right. Couldn't even get number
Congratulations.
Two. Thank you, buddy. All right. That is
talking to Jack.
That is going to end this shit show. So So we do actually, we have a guest for next week. We're going to.
You sure?
Yes. Yes. Oh man, I've had a hard time with guests this fucking past couple weeks. It's been ridiculous. But we're going to have Denise Clemens on. Now it's going to be a pre-recorded episode. So Mike, Jack, and I have to figure out a time that we can record this. Cause Halloween night is next Monday and, I'm taking my daughter out. So I am not going to be on the air cause she comes first. But we'll release it at 9:30 regular time, but it'll be pre-recorded.
Yeah, I got a lot of candy. I got to stuff with drugs and razor blades. So yeah, it's a busy night.
I'm going to be busy. Hey,
way to perpetuate the stereotype there, buddy. Right. Thanks.
So Denise is, she is the wife of Jack Clemens, who's been on the NASA scientist buddy of ours, who's was on with us with Mike Mullane. But his wife wrote a book recently about, you're going to think, what? She wrote a cooking book, right? About cooking and stuff. Yeah, right. Exactly. What? However,
I like food.
I told her we were all foodies and that we were all food people. But she gives talks at conventions about putting food into worlds like fantasy worlds or sci-fi
putting
worlds.
Putting food in the transporter room too.
Right. like hot Klingon guinea worms. No, but. She has this thing where she makes you come up with ideas about how food will influence culture and stuff in your writing. So it'll be interesting to talk to her about, you know, like if a certain cuisine is in an area, how that's going to affect the society and how that would affect your development of that race and how that would, because as we all know, you know, everything revolves around food in society. It really like it colors every aspect of what your society is. So it's just kind of neat to make authors think about that, you know, if they don't think to put food in their world, and this could be for gamers or, you know, whatever. So she's going to come on. She does a whole thing. She's got it prepared, does a whole thing on this. So it should be neat.
She's cool.
Really cool. And Denise is awesome. I love Denise. She's really cool.
Yeah, she's a great Jack. I mean, they're good peoples. I'll tell you that for right now.
I'll tell you that right now.
I can't wait.
They're real good.
Peter, David is just saying he's commiserating with you, saying he's going to be taking his kids out as well.
Oh yeah,
tricker, and or treating.
Yep, that is the way it is. Yep. No, I like taking her out. That's fun. That's a fun thing. It's one of my things that I really enjoy. Taking her out, she has a good time. So, and it only lasts so long because in a couple years she's either A, going to stop going out trick or treating, or she's going to be like, "Fuck you, Dad! You're not going with me. I'm going with my friends, and we're
going
to go.
I'm going bag snatching, Dad. I don't need you.
We're going to go terrorize the neighborhood, right? So I gotta get it in while I can. I only got a couple years left.
Yep.
So, yep.
All right.
Yep.
So let's wrap it up. All right, guys. Thanks a lot. Let's do the clues here. All right, you've just enjoyed another awesome episode of The MythWits. Join us for a live broadcast every week, at least maybe one more. Mondays at 9:30 p.m. Eastern Time to catch the full show. Jump into the chat room and ask our guests questions to catch the full show. Go to our chat. I did that part. If you miss our live show, you can always catch the encore episodes and the podcast at our website and on iTunes. iTunes, not iTunes, but iTunes. We are part of the TSR Podcast Network, and you can find us at MythWits.com and TSRNP.com. Oh, man, I can't read tonight. I'm having your problem, Mike. You can visit us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Do the like, follow, subscribe thing wherever it's appropriate. Please give us a bunch of stars and reviews and blah, 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 blah. Look, everybody, tell somebody you know to watch our show. We got to get a word of mouth. We don't have a lot of viewers. We got to get more. It's a good show. If you like it, tell people. Get them to watch. Hold them down. Fill them with drugs. So they can't get up. No, don't fill them with drugs.
It works.
Unless you really want to. And then don't tell them I said you to do that. So anyway, we are a C107.com production, and we're protected under Creative Commons. You know, share it. Just don't sell it or whatever. Make sure to check out C107.com. Join our mailing list. Blah, blah, blah. Thanks for listening, everybody. And again, tell your friends, please, write us a review, something. Help us out. Help a brother out. And Mike?
Mommy, I drew a penis.
Are you a lesbian? I don't know. All right. Good night, everybody.
Yup.